Good morning, my lovable children, estimable guardians, parents and all viewers. In the previous classes, we have already discussed about adaptation in plants, science standard for chapter 2. But today topic is adaptation in animals, very interesting topic also. Let's come to the topic. Adaptation in animals. What do you mean adaptation? Now, adaptation means adjustments. First, you know that what do you mean by adaptation? Definition of adaptations. Then, adaptation means the process of developing special features in the body to adjust to surrounding is called adaptations. That means, diagram though, see the diagram carefully. Polar bear, snow regions, Himalayan, camel, desert areas, elephant in forest. That this is the adaptations. That means the process of developing special features in the body to adjust to the surround, that is the adaptations. Then, millions of years ago, dinosaurs were present on the earth, they got extinct. One of the theories suggests that they could be extinct because of climate change. That means dinosaurs derived from two Greek words, dino means reptiles and Saurus means lizard. That means dino means terrific and Saurus means lizard. That means the two are the dinosaurs. Dinosaurs are two words, that means dino and saurus. And adaptation in animals by habitat. You know that natural habitats where animals live, that is called habitat. Then first terrestrial animals, that means the animals that live on land are called terrestrial animals. Like lion, camel, horse are terrestrial animals. And then the animals have strong legs to walk around and they can run fast. That means adaptation shown by camel. See the diagram? Camel, padded feet. Camel have padded feet. Hump, eyelashes, hair skin. See the diagram carefully. Camels live in hot and dry deserts, but they have humps to store fat to help them to stay without food. That means humps to store more fat and which help them to stay without food for several days. And that means the camels have padded feet. That means padded feet to lungs help to them walk comfortably in hot sand. That means desert areas. And in hot sand, they have long eyelashes to protect their eyes from the sand storm. Adaptation shown by polar bear. Animals like polar bears, penguins, and Arctic foxes live in cold regions. They have fur on their bodies to keep. See the diagram? Polar bear, they have fur on their bodies to keep warm. Keep them warm. And they store fat under the skin to be used during winters. This thick layer under skin is called blubber. Adaptation shown by snake. See the diagram? Snake. Snake does not have legs, arms or ears, but it crawls through grass, rocks to move to enter season. It can enter narrow in the ground made by the rats and find them and eat them. Aquatic animals. Aquatic animals, that means animals that live in water, that is called aquatic fish, sea snails, turtles are aquatic animals. They have fins and waterproof skin to suit their environment. The water animals have a board-shaped streamlined body. The water animals have board-shaped but streamlined bodies which helps them swimming. Aquatic birds and dogs have webbed feet. See the diagram. Webbed feet and to push water. And fish have gills. See the diagram. Fish have gills to breathe in water. Cranes and flamingos have long legs to wade in water. They also have beaks to catch fish. Amphibians. The animals that can live both in land and water, that is called amphibians. That means frog, salamander, toads, different type of amphibians. Frogs, toads and salamanders are example of these animals. And that means they breathe through our skin and when in water. On the land, they use lungs to breathe. And when on land, they jump around on their strong legs and in water, they swim with the help of webbed feet. Arboreal. Arboreal means basically the some animals like monkeys, squirrels and garden lizards spend most of the time on trees. That is called arboreal animals. And that means the special feature help them live in trees. Monkeys climb from one branch. Squirrel. monkey. See the diagram carefully. Squirrel, monkey. Arboreal animals have sharp claws and broad shaped girdles that support them during climbing. Aerial animals, the animals that fly on spend most of their time in air. That is an example of birds. Birds and insects are aerial animals. Birds and insects are aerial animals, and they have wings to fly and streamlined bodies to coat through the air, and they have light and hollow bones. The natural surrounding where animals live is called as habitats. Dogs have desks to push water, web feet. Salamander eat desks, amphibian. Special features of desk animals help them to live in or on trees, arboreal animals. Basically, to live on trees. Adaptation in behavior. Some animals, different type of adaptations in behavior to survive in extreme weather conditions. Some adaptation in behavior are described as follows: hibernation, estivation, migration. First, we know hibernation. Hibernation means, that means the polar bears, lizards, frogs, and during winter is called winter silk, also hibernation. That means during summer they eat a lot of food, in winter they become inactive and go to into deep sleep. Hibernation, basically frogs. Estivation, in hot and dry desert, some animals like snakes take a long sleep, and during hot summer month, this summer sleep is called estivation. But summer sleep is called estivation, like such animal snakes. But hibernation, that means a frog, the winter sleep, that is called hibernation. Keep remember. Migration. Siberian cranes have leave their homes in winter and fly thousands of kilometers to warmer places in search of food and shelter. And they go back to native places when winters, that means see the diagram, Siberian cranes. They go back to native place when winters there. Similarly, many other animals regularly move from one place to another place. That means, the regular movement of animals or birds in large number of from one region to some other favorable region is called migration. Then adaptation for food. Animals eat plants and other animals on the basis of their feeding habits. We can classify the herbivorous, carnivorous, parasites, scavengers. That means herbivorous, animals that eat plants and plant products, that is herbivorous, cow, goat, giraffe. See the diagram, giraffe, cow. Then next, carnivorous, animals that eat flesh of other animals are called carnivorous. That means animals that eat flesh of other animals are carnivorous. Example, lions, tigers, sharks and carnivorous. These animals have long sharp teeth to tearing flesh. Example, carnivorous like eagles. See the diagram, eagle. Omnivorous. Animals that eat both plants and animals are called omnivorous. That means examples, human beings, crows, bears and dogs are omnivorous. They have sharp teeth to tear flesh and flat teeth to grind food. Crow and bear. See the diagram. Some parasites. Some animals live on inside the bodies of the other animals to obtain food. That is called parasite. Mosquitoes, lice, etc. Mosquitoes, lice, stepper. That means they suck the blood and nutrition from the horse, and for this they have suckers and sucking tips. That mosquitoes, lice and stepper are some example of parasites. Mosquito, lice. See the diagram. Scavengers. Scavengers means they eat the flesh. These animals eat the flesh of dead animals. That means vulture, hyena. Vulture, hyena. See the diagram. They have strong and sharp beak to tear the flesh. Adaptation for protection. Animals are hunted, eaten up by other animals. Every animal tries to protect itself from enemies. They have different features for adaptation for protection from the enemies. Camouflaging. Camouflaging means, that means color and shape of some animals like chameleons, leaf insects, and they merge with the surroundings. They can merge, that means they can mix with the surroundings, and this is called camouflaging. That means example of chameleons. Leaf insects, that means with the help of camouflage, animal merges with surrounding and its enemies cannot see the prey. The adaptation protects the animals protect from their enemies. For example, chameleon changes a body color change according to the surrounding, escape from enemies. Artifices live in the polar region. They have brown coat in summers. They grow white fur in winter to merge with surrounding. Similarly, tigers, zebra, leopards have stripes, spots on their body to help them to merge with surrounding. Example, see the diagram, Arctic foxes. Cells and spines. Tortoise and snails have hard cells to cover the and protect their short body. Porcupines and hedgehogs, that means have sharp spines to protect themselves from the enemies. Strong legs, many animals like deer, tiger, leopard, giraffe and ostrich have strong legs. They are on very fast sensing danger. Poison, animals, insects, reptiles use poison to protect themselves. Animals like bees and wasps have stings. That means they use stings to ingest poison into their bodies, into enemies, when they come closer. Because they are, bees and wasps have methionic formic acids. So they, they use stings to ingest any animals, human beings, they can infection, so they can infect. So that is the, due to the methionic formic acid size. Elephants, hippos, whales are too big to eaten by animals, thus their size serves as adaptation for protection. Endangered animal, that means organisms can adapt to various conditions such as tiger, giant panda, blue whale. That means blue whale is the largest mammal in the world. That means endangered animals means the danger in becoming extinct. That means example, tiger, giant panda and blue whale. But extinct animals, that means which do not exist on the earth. That means which earlier existed are called extinct. That means, for example, dodo. Follow textbooks. Question, looking back, adaptation in animals, adaptation by habitats, terrestrial animals, aquatic animals, camel, home to store fat, padded feet and long legs, thick and less hairy skin, that means polar bear, fur on skin, fat store under skin, snake, scales to crawl, aquatic animals, dog, web feet, fish, gills, cranes, long legs, long beaks. Adaptation for food. Herbivorous eat plants, carnivorous eat other animals, omnivorous eat plants and animals, parasites suck blood and nutrition from animals, scavengers live on dead animals. Adaptation for protection. Camouflaging, chameleon and leaf insect change color, shells, tortoise and snail, spines, porcupine and hedgehog, strong legs, deer and tiger, poison, snake, sides, elephant, hippo. Amphibians live both on land and water, breath through lungs and skin. Arboreal animals live mostly on trees, strong arms, sharp claws and broad hip girdles. Aerial animals, wings, streamlined body, hollow bones. Adaptation in behavior, hibernation, winter sleep, estivation, summer sleep, migration, Siberian cranes. State questions are multiple choice questions. Follow textbook. In water, amphibians breathe through their skin. Number 2, this is an arboreal animal, monkey. Number 3, this is a parasite, mosquito. Number 4, it is strives to camouflage, zebra. True, false. 1, amphibians can live both in water and land, true. Number 2, a crab is an aerial animal, false. Bird insects are an aerial animal. That is a true. False. That is the a crab is an aerial animal. That is a false. Winter sleep of frog is known as perspiration. False. Winter sleep of frog is known as hibernation. Hibernation. That means winter sleep of frog is known as hibernation. That is the perspiration. That is the false. A chameleon can change its color. True. Fill up. 1. Birds can fly because they have streamlined bodies. Number 2. When animals go to sleep in winter, it is called hibernation. Number 3. Camouflage is an example of adaptation for protection from the enemies, that example of chameleon. Number 4. Porcupines have spines and or quills or prickles to protect their enemies, whatever you may write. Any words, spines or quills or prickles. That is right. And answer in one word. Number 1. Animals which no longer exist on earth, dinosaurs. Number 2. An animal with padded feet to help it walk in horse and camel. Number 3. Winter sleep of a frog is hibernation. Number 4. Animals that live on other animals for their food. Parasites. Number 5. Color changing ability of chameleon. Camouflaging. Number 1. Answer the questions. Why do animals adapt themselves according to changes in environment? First point. Animals adapt themselves to struggle for their survival, food and space. Number 2. Why do animals living in cold regions have fur on their body? Firstly, animals living in cold regions have fur on their body to keep them warm. Number 3. Why do Siberian cranes leave their homes in winter? What is the phenomenon called? Siberian cranes leave their homes in winter in search of food and shelter. Number 2. This phenomenon is called migration. Number 4. Differentiate between herbivorous and carnivorous on basis of their teeth. First, you know that the definition of herbivorous and carnivorous less than about the basis of teeth. First point, herbivorous. Animals that eat plant and plant product are called herbivorous. Carnivorous. Animals that eat the flesh of other animals are called carnivorous. First point, herbivorous. Second point, they have sharp cutting teeth at the front and strong grinding teeth. Carnivorous. Second point, they have long sharp teeth for tearing flesh. Third point, example of herbivorous, cow, goat, giraffe, etc. Number 3, example of carnivorous, lions, tigers and sharks, etc. Number 5, how are parasites different from other animals? First point, the other animals such as carnivorous eat dead animals. Second point, but parasites eat living animals such as mosquitoes, leeches, etc. suck the bloods and nutrition from their hosts. Number 6. What is camouflaging? First point, the color and shape of some animals merge with their surroundings are called camouflaging. Second point, example of camouflaging animals are chameleons and leaf insects. Number 7. What are endangered animals? Give two examples. First point, the animals that are in danger of becoming extinct are called endangered animals. And second point, examples of endangered animals, that means tiger, giant panda and blue whale, etc. This is the question answer. This is the question answer. And if there is any doubt, contact with me and read attentively. God bless you. Thank you so much.